Good podcast names are essential for success, so here are 8 mistakes to avoid when naming a podcast. Plus, if you want more podcast name ideas to choose from, I'm going to share the AI prompt that we use with our clients that you can put into ChatGPT or another tool to come up with lots more options. Mistakes people make when naming their podcast. Number 1, being too cute. Now, don't get me wrong. I love wordplay. I love rhymes. I love a good pun. But you want to make sure to try and use keywords that people might actually search for in the podcast directories. I have a good friend that launched a podcast and I think did 200 episodes before he realized that his cutesy name was hurting his business, and he ended up rebranding the whole thing. It was a huge process. Mistakes people make when naming their podcast. Number 2, being too generic. Imagine if I started a podcast and I just called it The Marketing Show. Is somebody likely to remember The Marketing Show for a brand new show they've never heard of? No, not likely. Mistakes people make when naming their podcast. Number 3 is naming it before you actually plan out some episodes. So I've seen people just fall in love with the name, they start recording, and then all of a sudden by episode 4 or 5, they realize some of the topics they wanted to talk about don't actually work very well with the name. I suggest, doesn't have to be very specific, but at least make a list of maybe what your first 10 episodes would be about, and then make sure that whatever name you choose fits those very easily. Mistakes people make when naming their podcast. Number 4, using the wrong words. And what I mean by that is using words that your audience wouldn't necessarily use. If you're in a more technical industry, but you're trying to attract beginners, maybe they don't know those terms, they wouldn't search for those terms. But even more than that, anytime in any of our content that we can use the exact words that our audience uses, it's going to attract them so much more because you're saying it the same way they would say it. Mistakes people make when naming their podcast. Number 5, using too many words. Now, Buzzsprout, I saw, recommends 4 words or less, which is great, but it is sometimes hard to stand out with only 4 words, or maybe you just can't quite make that work. So we usually tell our clients up to 7 is okay. If you have a longer name, make sure to put the most important words at the front, because in some views, in some apps, the name of your podcast will get cut off. By the way, mistake number 8 will actually help you shorten your title, and we'll tell you about that here in just a second. But if you are new here on the channel, we help entrepreneurs run their online business in half the time so they can be done by lunch. If that's something you'd like to learn more about, please consider subscribing. Check out some of our other videos. Mistakes people make when naming their podcast. Number 6 is being overly complex. Couple parts of this. First of all, you want it to be easy to remember so that someone who does listen can tell a friend about it. And then later, when that friend decides to look you up in their podcasting app, they can still remember it. And then the second part of this is you want it to be easy to spell. If you use a lot of technical jargon or words that people have trouble spelling commonly, this can make your episodes harder to find. So we want to avoid that if at all possible. Mistakes people make when naming their podcast. Number 7, choosing something already taken. I'll tell you how to check this in a second, but I had one person come to me and say, hey, my podcast is, you know, not getting discovered much and things like that. And I looked up the name of the podcasts, and there were at least 13 other shows with the exact same title, word for word. Search Apple Podcasts. That's the biggest podcast directory. Maybe Google, YouTube. You might want to search and see if there's any social media handles that match it. And maybe see if you can get the .com domain for your show as well before finalizing your title. All right, that ChatGPT prompt to help you come up with ideas in just a second. But mistakes people make when naming their podcast. Number 8, including the word podcast in the title. This is very common for people to do, but they're already seeing it in the podcast directory. It just makes it longer. You don't need it on there. If you are launching a show, the name is actually only one of 10 things you need to have a profitable podcast. Don't worry, we put together the whole list for you. It's free. We'll include the link in the description of this video. All right, open ChatGPT or your AI tool of choice and type this in. I have a, and then insert your core offer that you want to lead people to. So it could be a membership, a book, a course, whatever it might be. Called, then insert the name of it. Where, then insert who it's for, so your ideal audience. Next is the thing that your offer helps them do. Then you say, I need a, and then insert the vibe. Is it serious? Is it fun? Is it crazy? Is it lighthearted? Whatever it might be, insert that in there so that ChatGPT knows the tone you want. Podcast name, written at a 6th grade level. Why at a sixth grade level? Well, there's actually a lot of psychology behind that, but the main reason is you want somebody to be able to skim it quickly and decide if it's right for them or not. You don't want to make their brain work too hard when they're looking at a list of podcasts. One more thing to consider when naming your show, what's the format of your show going to be? Solo, interviews, co-host, sidekick? I've linked to a video on the screen right now. When you watch that, you'll see the upsides and downsides of each of those formats, which may affect how you name your show. So click that now. Lots more resources in the description of this video, including one of my favorite online podcast name generators. So check all that out, and we'll see you in the next video.